Welcome back to my channel where we focus on apartment tours on Tuesdays and Thursdays and something I'm genuinely interested in on Saturdays. If you are new here, don't forget to click that subscribe button, and everybody, please don't forget to like this video. One like equals $1 towards a new luxury apartment. Let's get it. The second unit, you guys, was so freaking pretty. I literally died when I walked into this room. The difference between an apartment and a townhome is an apartment is one level and a townhome is two levels or multiple levels. And just so you guys know, this is a condo grade building built with concrete, so it's great for fire prevention. Unlike the first one, it wasn't as well lit, but it was still pretty bright from the natural light, and honestly everything else in this unit made up for the lack of natural light. This townhome is $7,000 to rent. It is a 3-bedroom, 2.5 bath, and it is also 2,300 square feet. So let's take a look at this place because I think you guys are gonna die when you see it, to be honest. So again, like the first unit, you do have the darker cabinets, but this time instead of the white marble countertops, you actually have a like dark gray countertop. And I think that it really does make it look good. I do think that having white countertops would help brighten the entire kitchen up, but I don't think it's a bad thing because the lighting in there does still make it really bright. And maybe they were going for more of a dark look because not everybody does like the brightness that comes with white. All of the units have standard Gen Air appliances. And just take a look at this freaking stove. Like the gold accents on this stove, I am dead and I've gone to heaven. I'm obsessed. Everything in this apartment literally looks so chic. I don't cook often, but I would definitely cook a lot more if I had that stove. Now let me talk to you about these light fixtures really quick because I feel like, again, like I said in the first portion of this video, look at the lights in your apartment right now and try to tell me they're not some frosted light fixtures, because every single apartment you go into that I tour, we all have the frosted light fixtures because it's standard. It literally feels like you're in a chef's kitchen. I mean, you have that stainless steel light fixture. It matches all of the appliances. I feel like if you're really into cooking, you're really gonna love this kitchen. And also above the stove, it does have one of those things. I don't know what it's called. And this backsplash probably took maybe not just as long as the other one, but a long time as well, because they use tiny tiles again. Like, just thinking how much time, how much effort these people put in to making this apartment look good, like, it just makes me want to stay there so much more. They put some wood planks to make sure that it matches the dark cabinetry, and like I said earlier, it really just helps pull everything together. Not to mention how freaking big this island is. I'm not even kidding you guys, the camera's not doing it justice. You could literally fit 5 or 6 people across this entire island if you really wanted to. You have the luxury of having so much space in this apartment that you really can do whatever you want. And this living area, again, you have that gas fireplace. I mean, not a lot of places offer a gas fireplace or a fireplace at all, so having that is really nice because it can get really freaking cold during the winter. So moving into the living area, these floors, you guys, these floors, I literally cannot, they are killing me. They are real hardwood floors, and the type of wood is a stained bamboo, and I've honestly never seen anything like it. This is so gorgeous. And like I mentioned earlier, that living area is pretty big. You can mount your TV above the fireplace. You could get a nice big couch, whatever kind of couch you want, a coffee table and a rug. It really depends on what your vibe is, what you guys have, what you're buying. And then looking at this first room, again, it is pretty big. I would say that you can definitely fit a queen or a full-size bed in here. Like the first unit, I probably wouldn't put a king in here just because of the placement of the doors. This room does have a private balcony, which is super nice, like I said, for the first unit, because with that private balcony, you have privacy. And then you have a pretty large walk-in closet. I think it is really nice to have those shelves built into the closet already. Right when you walk upstairs, you have this entire additional area. You can put another table there or maybe some benches along the window. You also have a private terrace with the built-in gas grill. And this is a pretty large area. I mean, you could keep your dogs out here to hang out during the day while you're working if you work from home. You do also get a full-size washer and dryer in this unit, just like the last last unit and every single unit that is in this property. So these next two rooms are like abnormally large. They're freaking huge. This first master bedroom that we're gonna go into has so much room. You could definitely get a California king for this room. You can keep your dresser and your nightstands in here, whatever floats your boat. You do get that five-piece bathroom again. And then with this bedroom specifically, you don't even have to keep your dresser in your room because they gave you an additional closet that's just for dressers. I've never even heard of that. It's kind of weird, and the closet doesn't feel like it really has a purpose, but I'm sure so many people could use that extra storage in so many different ways. This room does have that private balcony as well. So the last room, honestly, I would say is probably my favorite. I think I would choose this room. It does have a private balcony, and on top of that, this is the biggest room, I believe. It can definitely fit a king size bed or a California king size bed if that's what you're going for with the dressers and the nightstands. I don't need two closets, but I do love that five-piece bathrooms. And then you do have a pretty big walk-in closet that I would be extremely satisfied with if I lived there. Literally everywhere you walk in this building is so luxurious, and it feels like you're inside of a luxury cabin that costs way too much in Aspen, and it feels so cozy. You do have a pool that comes with a great view and a few other lounging areas as well. This antler chandelier I really love, and that was part of the sky lounging area that's like kind of by the pool, but they had an event going on up there, so I didn't really feel comfortable filming, but trust me when I say that it's freaking beautiful up there. The other lounge spot is downstairs, kind of near the leasing office, or actually right next to it. And again, even though it's super well lit in this area and you're like literally looking at the street, it still does feel like you're in a really high-end cabin in Aspen because of the planks on the wall and the ceiling. Like, again, they really took the time to make sure that this place looks really, really good. They do have an entire private courtyard that has like a putting green and a lot of lounging areas where you can sit, and I do believe they also have like weather TVs out there. So this apartment tour is a little bit longer than a lot of the other ones, just because I really took the time to write out an entire script for you guys and make sure that everything was really perfect. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave me a comment down below, like and subscribe. It would mean the world to me. I just love you guys so much, and be sure and check out my apartment hunting series wherever it is. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. Fearless.